Who is your refuge and fortress? Your refuge and fortress. Stay tuned to your daily grace inspiration message on Feeding on Jesus International. Psalm 91 verse 2 is our reading Bible verse today. And it reads, I will say to the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him I will trust. Amen. Who is your refuge and fortress today? What are you saying of the Lord today? If you are saying He gave you the trouble you are presently in or an illness to teach you humility, it's time to change what you are believing Him about. If you really believe that God is the author of your problems, will you really be running to Him for help? Beloved, let's be like the psalmist who declared, I will say to the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him I will trust. The Hebrew word for refuge refers to a shelter from storms and danger. That is what God is to you if you boldly declare that He is your fortress and refuge. You are saying to Him, He is your shelter from storms and danger. This shelter is like a blanket as many Jews have in their homes in Israel today to shelter them from small-scale attacks. In the figurative sense, when you say the Lord is your refuge, you are also declaring that He is your place of hope. The Lord is also your fortress and refuge. He is your refuge and fortress. In Hebrew, the word used for fortress refers to a castle or a stronghold, a place of defense and protection against large-scale attacks. That is the Lord, your fortress. Isn't that beautiful? And isn't it a beautiful picture? Whatever you might be going through right now, you can declare that the Lord is your refuge and your fortress, your protection in both small as well as big attacks. Perhaps you have not been saying that God is behind your troubles. Perhaps you are not saying anything about the Lord at all. Perhaps God seems far away and you feel cut off from Him. If that is you, can I encourage you to take a break today from whatever you have on your busy to-do list and simply take time to dwell in His sweet presence? God is not distant. Sometimes we are just too distracted to hear His voice or sense His loving presence. Take a moment and see yourself in God's secret place. Abide under his shadow. Receive His wisdom and find rest for your troubled soul. The feeling of being distant from God is only a feeling, nothing more. God has promised His word that He will never leave you nor forsake you. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 5. Our Lord Jesus paid for you to have access to God's constant presence. Our Lord Jesus paid for you to have access to God's constant supply. Our Lord Jesus paid for you to have access to God's 24/7 protection and covering at the cross. Jesus cried out, my God, why have you forsaken me? When God turned His back to him, Matthew chapter 27, verse 46, Jesus took a place and was rejected by God when He carried our sins, so that today we can take His place of being in the constant presence of the Father and take He him as our refuge and fortress. Amen. What are you saying to the Lord today? Amen. Share this video and bless a soul. Be encouraged. Claim that the Lord is your refuge and fortress and reign in life now and always in Jesus' mighty name. Shalom. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Share this video and bless your soul. Also, subscribe to my YouTube channel for your daily grace inspiration messages. For your daily grace inspirations. Bye-bye. God so loves you, okay? Cheer up. Cheer up. After all, he came to die for you. Bye-bye.